भाइयों और बहनों द बाप डब्ल्यू पी शो।
हे फोक्स, वेलकम टू द बाप डब्ल्यू पी शो। दिस इज द सीजन फिनाले, द लास्ट एपिसोड, एंड वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस वर्ल्ड कैंप इंडिया। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट डिस्कशन, आई वुड लाइक आवर पैनल मेंबर्स टू इंट्रोड्यूस देमसेल्व्स क्विकली, स्टार्टिंग विद अभिषेक।
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज अभिषेक एके पिटेहाल। So I was a WordCamp, serial WordCamper, and I was a lead organizer for WordCamp Nagpur.
Hi, I'm Aditya. I've been a deputy at WordCamp Central. I've done a volunteer time there, and I've been attending a lot of WordCamps, organized a lot of them too.
So I'm one of the organizers for the Mumbai WordPress Meetup group. We've been doing WordCamps since 2014 through our meetup group. I was also an attendee at the WordCamp. That I basically started off all this WordPress community stuff after seeing that WordCamp happening.
I am Bigui. I am from Calicut, Kerala. I am organizer of Kochi and the Kozhikode meetup group. The Kozhikode one is started just 1 month ago, and I am organizing WordPress meetups since 2014. After Mumbai WordCamp, first 2014 Mumbai WordCamp, and I am one of the organizers of last this year WordCamp Kochi happened in 2017 February, and I like to be part of the community, and whenever I get chance, I will be attending WordCamps and WordPress meetups.
Hi, hello guys. This is Harshad Mane. I am one of the organizers for WordCamp Nashik. And I also do love to attend WordCamps. Apart from that, I also contribute to WordPress, organizing local meetups in colleges in Nashik. And that's it from my side.
So right off the bat, first question for each of you in the same sequence that we went in. When would you like to have a WordCamp? WordCamp India, when should it happen? What year do you think is a good year to think about? Starting with Abhishek.
2019 would be great.
Aditya?
Yeah, 2020 would be great if on the simple premise that usually we tell everybody to wait for 1 year before they organize a WordCamp, as in they organize meetups, everything, for at least 1 year, so that your WordCamp is sustainable. So I think if it has to be sustainable, then you have to wait for at least 3 years.
Yeah, Alex.
Like I said, as soon as we can. So I'm thinking 2018, and coming to the part where Aditya mentioned we can work towards this. Yeah, we can. We've already started the discussion. Probably in the next 6 months, we can do a tryout, probably do something online, get people talking together, get people into the conversation. And then by 2018, we might be ready. So I'm good for 2018.
Okay, 2018. Be good?
I am in favor of 2019.
And what about you, Harshad?
Yeah, 2018. End of 2018, like Alex said.
2018.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have two of us saying 2018, two of us saying 2019, and one person saying 2020. So this is the question for Alex and Harshad. Why 2018?
Yes, we have existing communities. Only thing is we need to get started talking together, or get on a collaborative mode. Probably something like what we do in our local community, we can do it at an India level. That is something we can achieve within 2017 itself. Okay. And logistics can be put together in 4 to 5 months. So 2018 is quite possible, is what I think.
Okay. Harshad? Why would you say it up 2018?
Yeah, no. As we all know, that there is a much possibility of happening WordCamp India. Maybe it might be 2018 or 2019, whatever the year is. But I personally think it should happen in 2018, because Mumbai is already having WordCamps from past many years. Pune is, I think this would be the third edition for WordCamp Pune. Nashik will be the second edition. In 2000 edition, most of the WordCamps will happen twice they will will be happening twice. So I think if we have the WordCamp in end of 2018, so and what I think is that once you have a WordCamp India, there is a possibility of more local meetups to join to start, and that will be a good environment created to like for creating the local meetups. So that's what I think, and I think 2018 is the good year to have, make WordCamp India happen.
Okay. So let me move on to folks who saying 2019, Abhishek and Bigul. So Abhishek, why do you think 2019 is a good year for WordCamp?
So 2019, 2020, anything after that is perfectly fine.
Okay.
The thing here is why we want to make WordCamp India.
Okay.
So Abhi, we are having WordCamp regional, like WordCamp Nagpur, Pune, Kolhapur, or Bhopal, Mumbai and other cities. Like, because वहाँ की local communities बनानी है, ठीक है? If you check out the map, अभी हम लोग India का आधा part भी cover नहीं कर पाए, so we need communities in east part, north में अभी बड़ी मुश्किल से चंडीगढ़, दिल्ली आई है, south में देखेंगे we have Kochi and Bangalore community, Hyderabad communities are there, but उनके WordCamp हुए नहीं है, ठीक है? So okay. Until at least those guys have this at least one WordCamp, तब हम सारे WordCamps को combine नहीं कर सकते and have a one UGF community get together.
Okay.
So 19, 20, so it will take time. It's practically not possible in 17 or 18, anything.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. That if we do in 2018, which communities are freezed or which city want to organize a local meetup, they can get a boost and they can start the local meetup. So what I'm saying is that if we try that top to bottom approach, it is also helpful. So that's why I said 2019. Well, I'm not denying that it should happen in 2019 or 20, but if it happens in 2018, it's also good.
Okay. And Bigul, why do you say 2019?
The main reason is we have to make sure the community is growing, because this year suddenly the many few meetup groups happened, and they started meetups, then organized a few WordCamps. But we have to make sure that all these activities are being continuously happening, and we can expect those number of WordCamps next year also. And another reason is that India is very wide area, a subcontinent. So we need, for example, now the WordCamps, if you look the WordCamps activities happening in India, it's almost like it is like north and western regions, only in the north and western regions. Okay. Mm-hmm. So maybe next year we can expect some, because Kolkata WordPress the community has formed and they organize one meetup. So maybe within 1 or 2 next year there will be more meetups, so we can expect WordCamp Kolkata. Same we can expect, we need more meetup groups in south and eastern side and the northeastern side. So we need some time to figure it out. So, and another reason is that, Mumbai, it's all set for Mumbai. But the thing is that what will be the next location after Mumbai? Because we can't, Pune is there, Nagpur is there, Nasik is there, but we can't go for the WordCamp India in Maharashtra itself. Once we had 1 or 2 meetup group in each state, active meetup group in each state, we can consider. So I think we can help, we can, as an experienced person, we can help out to figure this, and so it will be fine. And another thing is that we can go for 1 or 2 we can say 2 online events in 2018. So it will be, we can organize it as a pre-event, so it will give us more experience instead of going for a big one.
Okay. And then we have 2020 from Aditya. Why would you say 2020?
Yeah, so basically I look at WordCamps as a marker for a local community, and it's helping, and how is it growing, it's fine. And We also need to check how many, like if we ask ourselves how many WordCamps have we had, there have been basically just two WordCamps, which have been multiple WordCamps, like I think WordCamp Mumbai and Pune. How many of them have been conducted? So there'll be 10 this year, but how many will repeat next year, we don't know. We have not seen as yet a healthy culture of WordCamp lead or organizers change hands. That I would, so once that is said, then I think that should be said. If we start talking about those things today, then maybe it will become a matter of habit by 2020, and we should be ready with a large enough group of people who can take over from anybody or anyone to organize a WordCamp India, and that should take at least till 2020.
Okay, so if I had to summarize what all of us have said, now the folks who are saying 2018 are saying that there is already enough momentum, the community is already in a place where there can be a WordCamp India, and so that way we should push for it and have it, have a WordCamp India as soon as possible, possibly 2018. The folks who are saying 2019 are saying that before we start planning a WordCamp India, we should try and grow the community to regions and areas of India where there are no WordCamps, no meetup groups. So have, because right now there are only, the community is mostly limited to Maharashtra and a little bit of North India. So there's nothing in the East, there's nothing in the South. The third perspective that I have is that it's not enough to have WordCamps just all over India. What should also happen is, the reason we should take 3 years is because by then one of the lead organizers will have to step down, the next lead organizer will have to take over. So unless that happens once for all these WordCamps, we should not have a WordCamp India. The other three perspectives that I have right now. Before I move to the next part, what I wanted to ask was, now this has been partially answered by whatever you've said till now, but what are the things that you think we need for a WordCamp to happen? Like some things that we've discovered in this conversation till now is that we should have more coordination or collaboration between different organizers across cities. So Bigul said we should have one or two online events to make that work. Aditya said that there should be a healthy culture of lead organizer transfer. A WordCamp should have happened enough times, at least thrice maybe, because that's when one lead organizer will hand over to the other lead organizer. So all these WordCamps should happen at least thrice. The third that came out was there should be enough WordCamps across India for this to happen. So are there anything else that you think we need for a WordCamp India to happen? Are there any prerequisites, any requirements? As usual, I'll start with Abhishek.
Right now, I'm not sure why we need WordCamp India. So I can't say like what other things we will be needing for that. So
that's also a good question. I should have asked that. Let's start with that. In fact, let me switch the question. Why do we need a WordCamp India?
Over to Aditya.
Well, at the moment, we don't.
Okay, we don't need a word.
Over to Alex.
Can I just add to it? So, yeah, we don't really need a WordCamp India. Yeah. But it can be helpful if we can actually help WordPress grow to place, actually have a system or have a group of people who can actually spread WordPress in India and get more people introduced to WordPress or introduced to open source through WordPress. So that is something that I would really want from as a sort of goal set by WordCamp India organizers group or something that they want to come up with. But they should want something more than just a fancy event where a lot of corporate companies or agencies network, which is all great, and that is good, and that will probably happen at a WordCamp India. But it should not happen, that should not be the primary goal of the entire event to take place over 2 years or 3 years, or people to plan and collaborate to basically have a party for themselves. It should be more about getting more people included into the community and figuring out different ways to do that.
So like that though is mentioned, no? The two aims, the two supposed aims of a WordCamp are, one, it is meant to grow the community, get more people introduced to the community, and second, it's supposed to celebrate the local community. So in that sense, if you see WordCamp India can be a celebration of the Indian WordPress community,
So let's talk about WordCamp India as a concept. It has literally been passed around more or less in whispers. Like people have talked about it here and there. I myself have done that, but we've not really sat down and nobody's really written down, a blog post saying that, okay, I want a WordCamp India, I want to see a WordCamp India, inviting comments, inviting.
I did.
That was an April Fool's joke. I mean, I read that. But yeah, we've not seen much of a WordCamp India specific discussion in public. We've seen a lot of discussion on all other things, but. So I do think that there should be a healthy debate, or at least a request to actually ask people what do they want from WordCamp India other than a fancy conference.
What do they want? Alex, what would you say?
I put WordCamp India in a box which is a good to have and not a need to have box. All right. Okay. One of the things of WordCamp Mumbai or any other WordCamp is it has a local flavor. It has a local agenda somewhere hidden or very obvious. Okay. So you have talks which are more suited to that local organizing team and the goals also. So someone questions, ke ye theek nahi hai, why no talks for these kind of people? We go ahead and reply saying that this is how the local community sees it. This is how... So WordCamp India gives you a more wider goal saying ke don't tailor it for just that city, tailor it more for a country level. So country level agendas also can come forward and all. So if you see, look at say a WordCamp Delhi is quite different compared to most WordCamps because it has less developer focus. That agenda then gets a premium. More focused saying ki countrywide kya chahiye logo ko.
So but isn't that a problem? Won't it take a lot of time to figure that out? Because it's easier to figure out what's in the local community because the local community meets regularly, has meetups regularly, they're in touch. Whereas if you talk of pan-India stuff, there is nothing happening pan-India. That brings me back to Bigul's suggestion earlier that there have to be a couple of online events or offline events on a pan-India level for us to figure that out, and we need time to do that.
So we don't jump into a WordCamp India. So something which was suggested is that we do an online event like a WordSesh for India and we figure out how we work together, how we solve our differences or conflicts ko kaise resolve karte hai, and then we move to, so we do a trial kind of a thing, a actual online event first and then jump into a more expensive offline thing.
Let me move to Bigul and ask him. Bigul, do you think there is a need for a WordCamp India?
Yeah, it's not necessary, but it will be good if it happens. The main reason will be that, for example, the Central also in favor of WordCamps, and WordCamp Central is also in favor of regional WordCamps. The main reason for that, in 2015, WordCamp Europe has held in Sevilla. And before that, in Sevilla, there was not that much active community. Only Sevilla was active, and Rocio, Luis were active there, and they were organizing WordCamp for many years. Only Sevilla. And when after the WordCamp Europe in 2015 in Sevilla, and within 2 years, there were more than 5 WordCamps. Last year, 5 WordCamps have happened. So community has grown very much. That's one of the reasons Central also go in favor of regional WordCamps. So we can also plan the same. And I hope, for example, now it's only in India, it's only in Central and North. So after that, once it is, for example, another reason I am sticking in with, I'm in favor of 2019 is that we need an active community because WordCamp India is not a small event. And we must expect at least 1,000 or more than 1,000 people for that event. So we need a lot of preparations. We have to take a lot of preparations. So it will take time.
Yeah, I think, yeah, it might not be necessary to have WordCamp India, but I personally think that, see, the community will graduate. Community will never grow. Much like today, there are 100 members in your local group. So tomorrow, it will this community will graduate, grow, and it is growing. But what I think is, if we have a WordCamp on such a large banner, I think there are more possibility to grow the community, and where the community has not been started yet, they can get a chance to it's like know more about what WordCamp is, because I have met many WordPress developers who work on WordPress but don't know what are local meetups, how to educate people with WordPress, how to share their knowledge with the help of WordCamp India banner. We can help other communities or the community who wants to start a local meetup group in their city. We can boost up them and they can start a local meetup, and community will gradually grow after WordCamp India. So I think there should be a high chance for having WordCamp India and in 2018. That's what I feel.
Okay. So isn't this like a chicken and egg problem? Like, for example, like 2 days ago, there was a post from on make.wordpress.org/community. There was a post which talked about doing an introduction to open source workshop. So the idea behind that is to start a community or have events in places where there is no community, so that a meetup group can be started, a community can be started and then sustained, and then become a WordCamp. Because what I understand, when you try and apply for a WordCamp, when you want to have a WordCamp, the precondition is that there should be a local, active, healthy community. And since Central has already started pushing for events that can help sprout a new meetup group or a new community, isn't this like a little, little reverse way of thinking, that there should be a WordCamp and then there will be a community? Wouldn't that, I somehow get confused between these two opinions. Anybody would like to add to this?
So just a small effort that we are doing in Nagpur community, like in WordCamp Nagpur, there were around 30 students from Shegaon, that is around 300 kilometers from Nagpur. So that's more close to Aurangabad community. So apart from Shegaon, there were students from Wardha, then Gondia, Amravati, and these cities are like pretty enough big cities compared to Nagpur. Okay? And companies are there, people are there, but there are no communities. So right now what we are doing is like we have planned to have a meetup over there in those cities. So because since people came down from that place to this WordCamp, so we are conducting a meetup over there. So let's try to create more communities before going for WordCamp.
Yeah, I don't agree that a larger WordCamp or WordCamp India will actually kick off local WordCamps or local meetup groups or encourage them to join the chapter. I don't think that will happen. That will happen maybe if so. I mean, that can happen to some local community members who might be able to go to a WordCamp India, attend it. And let's be honest, there'll be 1,000 people who will be attending WordCamp India, or maybe 2,000. But even if there are 5,000 in India, that's a very small number of people who are actually going to be doing web development or even using WordPress in smaller, very small towns and small cities, villages, etc. So if you're expecting WordCamp India to lead the way to more local involvement, that way that's not going to probably happen. I don't see that happening, because even in the past, WordCamps in India have not necessarily been always helping a local meetup group to kick off. We have examples previously, the WordCamps don't happen anymore. So I don't think that central growth of top-down growth of community will happen. That should not, it probably should not happen that way either.
So let me ask this question in a different way, or put it in a different way. Like I said, Central has started activities that are meant to, you know, increase or start communities in newer places. And second, increase participation in meetups. So earlier, what would happen is we as organizers would have to think of events, think of speakers, get speakers, decide on a plan, decide on the content and do a lot. Now, since Central is giving us more formats, I'm hoping, I mean, this is based purely on my hope and expectation. Right now, there is one event, but I'm hoping that there'll be more such events that will come out from the foundation, from the direction of the foundation, that this is an event, this is the session plan, this is what you can do, this much time it will take, if you need money, this is the funding that we can give you, etc., etc. So do we think that that is the right approach, or is it, are we still about there should be a WordCamp and then a community will automatically happen because of the WordCamp? So, or let me say it this way, Harshad said there are 10-15 people who come to a WordCamp, right? Like that used to be true. I know that it used to be true in Pune as well. The same kind of people turn up again and again. Shouldn't we be focusing more on making sure that our local meetup groups reach out to more people, grow a little, expand a little, involve people who are not involved in the community yet, do that, focus on that, and when that happens, and help whatever neighboring communities we have. When that happens, the stage will automatically get set for a WordCamp India. We won't be having this discussion. We'll be rather having a discussion, how do we go ahead and do a WordCamp India? Does that make sense, or is there something wrong with my thought right now?
Yeah, that makes sense. Like doing reaching out to more local people and educating how WordPress can educating people about WordPress and letting them know about how and WordCamp, what is a WordCamp, and why you should attend a WordCamp. So educating people in the local community, I think that's a good approach.
I'd like to counter what Aditya mentioned about this top-down approach where we'll first do a WordCamp and then we'll look at the community growth. So that has not worked. That has probably not worked because we didn't set expectations from these guys who did that top-down approach, which where they organized the WordCamp and promised a meetup will we get kicked from that area and all those things. So that expectation had not been set. So probably that expectation should have been set. Give you a boost, it will allow you to get larger focus, more people. So instead of 10-20 people showing up for a meetup, here you can organize an event for 200-300 people and then look at who joins your community and all those things. So that was there. Further, one more thing which interestingly happened at WordCamp Central, I being a deputy, I was part of this training program which has started for deputies. So out there, they have things like they tell you, it talks about things like principles of open source, how it applies to our community, like simple things like egoless participation. Okay, these are things that me and Aditya discussed when we started off, but we didn't put it in these kind of words. We understood about open source as to how we want to keep this open, where there's a group, different people participating. We keep channels open so that this, and plus we allow new organizers to come up and those organizers can take over and start this. They only need to show up for meetups. They need to be involved. So these are things that we discussed and we allowed people to move forward with. But yeah, the deputy training program, it puts things more in a more clear perspective. So having things like this way, training programs or something like that for and then setting expectations that this is expected out of you, so that will probably allow that top-down approach to work. Also somewhere I feel that we might think that a lot of people are not being touched by our WordCamp, but I think that somewhere we are myopic because we are in that whole swing of that WordCamp. We are in our own little friend circle also. We don't end up meeting enough people, or probably not realizing there are a lot of people who have attended and like interacted with the community, but have probably not interacted with us. Okay, so a simple example I'll give you is Priya, the girl who works in my office. She attended WordCamp Mumbai, and I knew this only because when she turned up for an interview out here, she told me that I have seen you at WordCamp Mumbai.
So I totally understand that part. My question is this, that there is a particular need to create like a buzz in a local community to get the community kickstarted or to grow the community further, take it to more people. So what Central now has proposed is a kind of event between a meetup and a WordCamp, like the introduction to open source is supposed to be the first such initiative. But I'm guessing I know that there'll be more such things that will happen. So if Central is trying to give us the kind of thing that will create a buzz locally, get people interested in WordPress, get them together in a good event, which is not still a WordCamp, which is not the scale of a WordCamp or the level of a WordCamp, somewhere in between a smaller event, 1 day, 3 hours, 4 hours, something like that. if that is happening, if there is something that will satisfy this need of ours to create a buzz, to create a community or grow the community, then why put that load on a WordCamp? Why not we as organizers focus our efforts there so that, you know, more communities and more things start flourishing, and then let the WordCamp happen organically from in a bottom down approach when there are ways and methods available to us, when we've seen that in the past that is how things have happened. There was nothing that till now, no?
At the start of the year early, Central had already mentioned that they want to be able to support other events and activities. So this is something that has been put on an agenda at the start of the year itself. All right, this whole open source training program comes from the idea that if we can grow the open source community pool itself, that would somewhere impact the WordPress ecosystem as well. So, yeah, but that's then that's part of that said, somewhere like we need to look at our local community and say that, okay, there is adaptation for open source products, but there is no understanding of this open source culture. So somewhere we need to look at our own objectives, ki whether this suits us. So this open source training wala part, I would say ki, because it might be set for like newer communities, I think it should be done in existing communities as well. And something which has been already mentioned, if we can make it happen without the need for financial assistance or something, if we already have existing venues, we have speakers, then we can go ahead and just do this. And I think we'll be doing it.
And but that this particular program also has half of it is on the philosophy and the ethics of WordPress. There is on open source. So the thing that we're talking about open source culture, this particular event that is suggested has half of it is introduction to the open source culture, using WordPress as a gateway, and second half is to introduce people to what is possible with WordPress. Not like getting, it's not a training program, it's more like a workshop where people sit down and figure out what are the benefits of FOSS or what is the moral philosophical implications of FOSS. Second part is where they sit down and understand what is possible with WordPress. What are the things that they can do with WordPress? There is no installing WordPress, there is no creating pages, blog posts, etc. That's also there, that's also possible, but the primary thing is this, to understand the philosophy of open source, and second, to understand what is possible with WordPress without, you know, if I'm a regular person who's never used WordPress, never used open source, I can get introduced to what all is possible when I use an open source tool. That's a specific event, but generally, I'll repeat myself. The question was that since there is now a method and an avenue or a process by which you can kickstart a local community without going to a WordCamp, without going to a scale of a WordCamp, without doing a regular meetup somewhere in between, then isn't a better idea to focus on that rather than trying to do a WordCamp India to boost a local community? Do a smaller event that's more manageable, easily done, doesn't require a lot of money, doesn't require a lot of coordination. Start doing that instead of trying to do a WordCamp India in a place where there's no community and hoping that it'll start a community.
No. So the goal is not to use WordCamp India as a launchpad for a city community, but the goal of WordCamp India should be to probably kickstart multiple communities. Or give that kick to multiple communities where, because it is WordCamp India, a lot of people will want to come. All right. Mumbai is a big city. Delhi is a big city. Let's rule them out. If it is a WordCamp Nashik or a WordCamp Ahmedabad or a WordCamp Kanpur, someone is not going to come from Bangalore or Chennai or Kolkata that easily. They will think twice before they do that. But if it is a WordCamp India banner, they'll definitely not want to miss it. And that probably helps them come and experience it. And then they will go ahead and kickstart something locally.
Okay, so that takes me to the last question. Unless somebody wants to add anything to this.
So if it is somebody who actually has to go from Bangalore to Ahmedabad for a WordCamp India, then it sort of becomes inaccessible, right, for a lot of people who do not have the money to travel. It's we are talking of India ultimately. A lot of people do not have the resources, the time to take off from work to go for 4 days or 5 days, travel by train, etc. and give that kind of time and space to actually go there to get inspired to start a local community back home. So I think that is that seems like a, again, something that's going to serve people who already are going to show up to other WordCamps, who anyways have the resources, maybe having two thoughts or maybe having a doubt or two, but I don't see that as very accessible.
Okay.
See, this accessibility part, yeah, it is not as accessible, but it's at least more accessible than, say, a WordCamp Europe to people, all right, or a WordCamp US or something, all right. Further, if it is not accessible to all, what it at least does is it gives someone the idea that you need to do this locally. It brings at least someone who will be that person who will be that flag bearer for that city. So accessibility, yeah, it is not the most ideal situation, but at least something is better than nothing. So it serves that purpose at least, is what I feel.
In that sense, if accessibility is an issue, I'll come to Harshad. If accessibility is an issue, what that thought can be put to have the WordCamp in a city that it's cheaper to live in, like which is like cheaper to stay for people for 1 or 2 days, which is like easily reachable, because second class ka fare in India, mostly anywhere in India, is around $500. If you have it somewhere in central India, say MP or somewhere in south of Maharashtra, it's like 500 rupees from all over India getting to the east or south side of Maharashtra, or getting to say MP. Is very easy, like maximum one day ka trip, 500 rupees. And if it is like a smaller city, on the top of my head, let me just say Gwalior. I don't know what city, but let's say it's Gwalior. Very cheap to stay in, hotels are cheaper, etc., etc. So you can do something like that. That can be sorted. You know, instead of having a 2-day WordCamp, you can have a 1-day WordCamp. All those accessibility issues can be sorted if you decide, okay, there has to be a WordCamp in India and we should go ahead with it. Then you can discuss whether how can we make this very accessible? What are the things that we can do to make this very accessible? Sorry, Harshad, you're saying something. I'll come to you, Aditya, as well. I know you want to say something.
No, I just wanted Harshad. To say on this, Alex, and your thoughts that, yeah, it can be made accessible. We can't just rule out because of such, and because driving isn't one of the this thing. It is a major issue to having to commute from one state to another, from one city to another. So it can be worked out. So because of that reason, it is inaccessible for so-and-so city to attend the WordCamp. So that cannot be the reason for not having WordCamp India, or to rule out this thing. So that's why I'm sticking on both of your Saurabh's and Alex's points, accessibility can be worked out. If that is the concern for not having this WordCamp India.
Yeah, Aditya, you're saying something?
Yeah, so accessibility can be worked out, but what we're talking about is having local meetup start or local group start, local activity start from WordCamp India. I find that concept itself is really unrealistic. It has to be, it can happen if WordCamp India is doing other things apart from that one single event, as an organization or a loose affiliation of people. But I don't think it can happen just by having an event and having people from all over and then teach them how to start meetups and train them how to be open source enthusiasts.
So can I say this, like that can we take
that as a secondary? That has been taken up at WordCamps. At WordCamp Kanpur, a lot of UP city guys who had turned up for the Kanpur meetup WordCamp, they wanted to know how do we get started. So we did announcements. A lot of them had personal chats with other WordCamp meetups or meetup organizers. You have to put it in the local agenda, where you, other than just the talks or other than just the sessions, there will be workshops, or there will be people can interact with, ask questions. Know how do we get started with a meetup or with a WordCamp in our city.
So can I say this, like this helping fuel the local community is, I think that's more like an effect of a WordCamp rather than the reason for a WordCamp India. That obviously is an effect. Rather than going deeper into this, we obviously, as the time progresses, as we start discussing this more, I'm sure this is not the first and the last discussion. This is the first public discussion that we've ever had. So I'm hoping this is not the last public discussion. I'm hoping we'll talk more about it over a period of time. But that brings me to the last question. Should it should a WordCamp India happen in an established community, which is already established, which is already proven their organizing skills? Or should it happen in a place where there is not much of an established community and then use the effect of a grand event, like Harshad said, the banner of WordCamp India to you know, keep that as one of the considerations? So where do you think a WordCamp India should happen, starting with Abhishek?
So I have again the same question. What will be the objective of the WordCamp India? Agar objective hai ki local community banani hai, then it will be good to have in a new place. But again, फिर वहाँ पे एक task बनता है कि like
so that can be a secondary objective, no? That can be one of the objectives.
That is one of the objectives. ठीक है.
हाँ.
Mostly I will recommend कि established community में होना चाहिए because they know how to execute the things. Because 2 months back we had a WordCamp Nagpur and we understand what kind of things we have gone through.
Okay. Okay, so you're saying that it should happen in an established community instead of like a new place. What do you say, Aditya?
So, it should happen in an established community. As I said, that it should be after 3 years. If there are 10 WordCamps or there are 20 WordCamps next year, in 3 years, we'll have 20 WordCamps with 3 different years that they've had WordCamps and maybe 2 different lead organizers. So maybe 60 people who can be lead organizers or have the experience of being lead organizers. At that point of time, it doesn't matter who actually organizes a WordCamp or which city met organizes a WordCamp. But if you want me to name one, then
yeah, Abhishek, you don't name a city. Any city that you have, you think should
Mumbai.
Mumbai. Okay. This says Mumbai, Abhishek says Mumbai. And both of them say Mumbai because it should happen in an established community. What do you say, Alex?
See, this, I agree with Aditya about the whole established community part. Okay. Also with Abhishek, because of the logistic nightmare that a new WordCamp can come around. All right. And like, for example, we had it very easy in 2014 because we just focused on basics. We didn't have like any set expectations. People had not been to like a lot of other WordCamps before that. So we said we'll stick to the basics. We'll get other things right. We'll get our speaker sessions right. We'll get community involvement right. We'll get all those things right. And we'll focus on basic logistics. WordCamp India, you can't do this. You can't say that we'll just get basics right. We won't do swag. We won't do a t-shirt. We won't do these things because usme jyada time lagega. All those things we can't do. So logistics, yes. So uske liye established community lagega.
Okay. So what do you say, Bigul? Oh, sorry. Wait. Alex, what city?
What city? Mumbai.
Yeah, Bigul. Same question. Which city? Established community, new community, which city?
Yeah, of course, Mumbai for the first time. And,
okay.
We need established community. Otherwise, it will be tough to handle. I think as an experienced event, we can follow. For example, WordCamp US, I think they held 2 times in one city. After that, they moved to other cities.
What do you say, Arshad?
Yeah, as far as the city is concerned, I vote for Mumbai because I also think that it should happen in the established city.
I want to ask this to all the organizers. All of you have been WordCamp organizers. Is an organizing team absolutely smooth? Is the coordination very easy? Are there tiffs and quarrels that happen within a city's organizing team?
Yeah, definitely. Most definitely it happens.
So let's say we start talking about a WordCamp India. Whenever there's a WordCamp India, it will be expected that all the organizers from every city will be working together. Like Aditya said that more than it happening in an established city, what would happen is because there will be enough communities, enough WordCamps, there will be enough people to coordinate with each other. Like Bigul said, there should be some offline events. There should be a WordSesh like thing. So when people get used to that kind of coordination, it would not matter what city it happens in. And I would like to add one more point that we discussed earlier. It's going to be a little difficult or expensive or accessible For people, for a WordCamp to happen in a big city like Mumbai, it's gonna be very expensive for anybody to have a hotel room in a city like Mumbai for 2 days or 3 days, compared to say a Nashik or even a Bhopal.
No, but like a city like Mumbai has other alternatives. Like there are a lot of people I know who come from Gujarat, stay in a lot of ashrams and accommodations which are probably free as well. All right, so yeah, and many people also have relatives, cousins or someone in like cities like Mumbai where they can probably stay the night or stay for a couple of days. Vaisa, we've never like focused on people coming from
Mumbai. Does have backpacker hostels. Mumbai does have backpacker hostels, so even have cheaper options.
So that also brings us to the earlier discussion. Accessibility is a problem that can be solved. Like we can, if you decide on a particular city, I'll just summarizing. So one thought was that the WordCamp should happen in Mumbai because there is an established community and there's a track record of lead organizer handovers, etc. And it'll be nicer, it'll be easier to logistically to do a WordCamp in Mumbai. Accessibility parts can be taken into consideration. What Aditya said is that ideally, it should not matter. It won't matter what city is it in. If the community is in a certain place by then, it won't matter what city the WordCamp happens because all the organizers will go and work together. So if the Mumbai WordCamp is happening smoothly, it's not because it could be because the organizers are doing it that well. They have that much experience. It should not matter what city, what resources are available in the city. This is, I guess, the first time we've publicly talked about a WordCamp India. Before I end this show, I don't have a lot more to talk. I'm sure we have a lot more to talk, and I am hoping, in fact, I have already announced a show where we want to talk about local activities, meetup activities, problems faced by different meetup organizers, try and talk more often. I hope we are able to have such more public conversations, maybe probably a live conversation where others can also participate. Right now, this is getting recorded. This is pretty private. I mean, nobody can add to this conversation right now. Maybe we can have more such conversations. Like Bigul said, we can have more online, offline events. Central has proposed certain events. Probably we should do more of them. Personally, I'm of the opinion that if we, instead of thinking of when should we have a WordCamp India, where should we have a WordCamp India and how, if we focus on this part, how do we get coordinated? How do we start helping local communities grow? This WordCamp India plan would automatically start taking a concrete form. You automatically know where to do it, when to do it, what year, etc. Parting, like any parting messages from anybody, like before we bring this conversation to a conclusion.
Happy Independence Day.
Happy Independence Day. Yeah. This should air on August 15th. Anything else anyone would like to add?
One thing I would like to add. Can I?
Yeah.
So what Aditya was saying, you shouldn't make this WordCamp India a marketing tool and make it about the big boys coming and partying and talking business. All right. So somewhere, if you look at the WordCamp community out here, it's mostly freelancers or small business owners or employees of company who are not like really like supported or pushed by their company to get involved. All right. So somewhere the big boys need to come to the table without bringing their egos. Although right now the big boys at the table are with their egos and not with their hard work.
Yeah.
So they need to put in hard work and keep their egos behind and come on the table, discuss, help out. All right. A lot of them have supported us financially, but like I think somewhere we need hands on deck more than money, right?
So I guess, once like now this conversation has started, we've had a public conversation. This is like the first one, but hopefully we'll have more. I'm guessing we can expect more people to join in, people who are interested in having a WordCamp India, people who feel that there should be a WordCamp India and they feel they should have a contribution to it. I guess they should start joining this conversation. I invited a lot of people personally for this particular episode. I called a lot of people. And out of the people that I've called, the five of you have turned up. There are a couple of people who did not respond to me or declined to reply or did not turn up at all. So I'm hoping that, you know, maybe because this show was being done by a private entity or something. I guess if we are independently able to do this more often, have like a hangout like this, just have a hangout where people can come down and join in and talk about certain things from time to time, have it more regularly. I guess we'll get there. Like we'll get where we need to be to have a proper WordCamp India that everybody is in coordination with, everybody has the right objectives in mind, egos are set aside, and self-interest is taken out of the table. I guess that will happen automatically or organically as we start talking. I feel so. I don't know. Any message that you would like to give to the viewers who are watching this? People who will
happy
watch.
Happy Independence Day.
Yeah, that is done, dude.
Okay.
Bigul, any message for people who are interested in WordCamp India?
Okay. The people who are watching this video, I have a request. Please try to use WordPress is now WordPress translations are available in 3 Indian languages. So whenever you get a chance, it's in Gujarati, Marathi, and Hindi. So if it is these three, you are using your mother tongue is one of this language. Please use it native version. So hope it is because now Indian languages are in the usage count of WordPress native WordPress. The language count of WordPress native versions are very very low. So it would be great if you can use that.
There is a Global WordPress Translation Day on September 30th.
Ah, yeah.
Check out wptranslationday.org.
wptranslationday.org. Yeah, I'll paste a link in the description in the video.
Yeah.
Harshad, any message for?
Yeah, make sure you do bookmark November 5th of this year. It's WordCamp Nashik, the second edition. Please do attend WordCamp Nashik because this time we are trying to have more sessions and workshops. So this will be another great event for Nashik. So in the WP platform, I'll again request you to attend WordCamp Nashik, which is happening on November 5th, 2017.
I'm going to have a season 2. I'll have a episode on WordCamp Nashik in season 2.
Yeah.
Like 1 month before the WordCamp.
Yeah, sure.
Abhishek, any message?
See you at WordCamp Delhi.
WordCamp Delhi is in, I think, 8 more days.
Yeah, next weekend.
Finally, anywhere, if you meet up, if you want to know more about WordCamp India, ask around and actually talk about it because it's been really talked about in whispers. And I think people should just talk about it so there'll be more discussions in the open and we'll have probably something good will come out of it.
Good.
So it doesn't matter who you are, just talk about it.
So yeah, thank you folks for your opinions, your time, your ideas. This was very helpful. And to the audience who's watching this, I'll just give you a summary. The discussion that we had is WordCamp India should happen. There is a difference of opinion on when. We're more or less sure about why it should happen and what needs to be done for WordCamp India to happen. So if you're interested, don't think about whether you belong to a large company, if you're a CEO or a director or somebody like that. As long as you're interested, I guess the moral of the story is start participating in the conversation. We have a group on Facebook. It's called WordPress India, JWP. You can search on Facebook and find it. Join the group. Anytime a conversation starts, you can join in. If you feel like starting a conversation, feel free to start a conversation there. On my part, I would like to invite all the people here and anyone else who's interested in discussing this to join in for more discussions. I'll be announcing and inviting you from time to time. If you're interested, please get in touch with me. It's a good idea. A WordCamp India should happen whenever, however, we'll figure that out. The things that we need to do, we'll figure that out as the time progresses. But one of the things that we need to do urgently is start talking more openly, more publicly. And let's do that, and let's hope that a WordCamp India happens soon. Jai WordPress, happy Independence Day, have a nice day. Bye, guys.
WP Show.